This is New York's Lenox Hill Hospital, where each year close to 3,000 babies are born. And 13 blocks away, New York Hospital delivers another 3,700 babies every year. Each of these babies is, of course, special, but during the next 90 minutes, only one of them will be showered with wealth and fame beyond comprehension. Because tonight is the third anniversary show of Late Night with David Letterman, and the first baby born during this show will become the Late Night baby, the most powerful, most celebrated, most envied infant in history.
From New York, where rebel gunfire in the surrounding countryside cannot mar our official celebration, it's Late Night with David Letterman. Tonight, it's our third anniversary show with appearances by Eddie Murphy, Steve Martin, Jay Pauley, Billy Idol, and Bill Murray. Also, stupid pet tricks, dropping stuff, viewer mail, and other golden moments. And now, a man who's backstage putting rosin on his tongue, David Letterman.
Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to our, this is going to be our third anniversary celebration, and we're so happy you could join us. Now, tonight on the show, we are going to have highlights from previous shows, and I think they're MASH, Taxi, and Mary Tyler Moore. So you're in for a wonderful evening of viewing, but you know, the one thing that I'm really proud of over the last 3 years, the support from this network, NBC, has been unbelievable, but sometimes you get the feeling that not all executives are going to the same meetings. I'm coming down in the elevator to the studio earlier this afternoon, and an executive gets on. I'm not sure the man's name, I'm not sure what he does, but we know for sure he's an executive. And he says to me, "Well, I guess you're really excited, getting excited now, aren't you?" And I said, "Yeah, as a matter of fact, I am." And he said, "Me too, I really love the Pro Bowl." So, we did some figuring out this afternoon. In 3 years, we have done 502 shows. There have been 3,800 commercials and 136 surprise walk-on visits by Bob Hope. So, quite a night. I'll tell you what, say hello to Paul Schaefer, and then I'll tell you what's going on here. Gentlemen, how are you? Paul, nice to see you.
David, good to see you. Three crazy years, three nutty cuckoo kind of years.
And tonight with the band, mention who's with the band tonight.
Oh, are we ever thrilled? We got him. He's ours. Mr. David Sanborn is
David, thank you very much for being here. Tonight, what we're going to do is we're going to take a look at things that we've done over the last 3 years that we think are well worth repeating or close. So, we'll be doing that. But in addition to that, as you saw at the beginning of the show, the first baby born during this 90-minute period at either Lenox Hill Hospital or New York Hospital will become the official late-night baby. And gosh, what a way to come into this world, huh? So, I'll tell you what let's do. Let's check in now with our remote crews and our correspondents. First of all, we're going to go to Lenox Hill Hospital here in Manhattan at 77th and Lexington Avenue. And our correspondent there from NBC's NFL 85, Mr. Bob Costas. Bob, tell us what's going on there at the hospital right now.
Well, David, as you know, I'm standing on the sixth floor of Lenox Hill Hospital, and right behind me, through these very doors, two women actually are in labor. And the attending nurses have told me there is no way to guarantee that they will deliver during the show. However, in situations like this, Dave, You never know. So we'll be back to you throughout the program. This is Bob Costas, standing watch at Lenox Hill Hospital.
Thank you very much, Bob, and I know you'll do everything you can to lend a hand there. Now let's go to our second hospital. This is New York Hospital. It's located at 68th Street and York, here in Manhattan. And our correspondent there tonight and throughout the evening, the voice of the World Wrestling Federation and host of TNT, Mr. Vince McMahon.
This is such an auspicious occasion, as a matter of fact. One of the ladies that just gave birth earlier on, Mrs. John Martino, we may be interviewing the father, John Martino, but right through this office, the former head of pediatrics has decorated this office unbelievably in hopes that we will have a very, very big birthday party here. So we're very much looking forward to this hospital, New York Hospital, being the one deemed having, of course, the late night baby.
All right. Probably not a bad idea to have some oxygen standing by for Vince. Okay, all right, there you have. The scene is set. The first child born at either of those hotels will stop the proceeding at, well, I keep saying hotels, at either of those hospitals. In fact, if you have a child that's going to be born in a hotel, phone us now and we'll set up. Okay, so that's what's going to happen here tonight, hopefully. Now, the next thing we're going to do, for 3 years, every Thursday evening on this program, we have taken a few moments out to answer our voluminous viewer mail. Tonight, we are going to show you a random sampling of our viewer mail and the responses to said. This is letter number one, and I'm not sure exactly when this came to us, but it begins, "Dear Dave, you know how before a commercial break the technicians bring the audio down on your microphones and they turn them up on Paul's band? Well, invariably this happens and you lean over and you say something to your guest. Could you please let us in on what we're missing? For instance, tonight Julia Child was on. What did you lean over and say to her?" This comes to us from Holly Barter, Alexandria, Virginia. Well, Holly, that's a good question. You know, we do turn up the volume on the band before going to commercials so we can all enjoy the music here in the studio, but I really don't remember exactly what I did say to Julia Child that night, so I think we'll just take a look at the videotape and try and listen in on that conversation.
Discuss. We'll be back with Julia Child. Julia, how about a dance?
Too bad Vince wasn't with us that night to break it up. Now, letter number two begins, "Dear Dave, my boss thinks that you are pond scum. Therefore, I must agree with him or I will lose my job. Sorry, deepest regrets." It comes to us from Jeff Weinrack, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Well, Jeff, I can see why you would want to meekly agree with your boss, but sometimes things don't work out quite the way we expect. Take a look at this film entitled Getting Along at Work, prepared by the Department of Commerce in conjunction with the National Council of Churches.
Jeff Weinrack worked at Donorama, a small donut shop in Milwaukee. One day, Mr. Kenyon, the manager of Donorama, asked him a question.
"You know, Jeff, I think David Letterman is pond scum. You agree with me, don't you, Jeff?"
"Gosh, should I stand up to him and tell him what I really think? Or should I be a coward and go along so I can keep my miserable little job?"
"Well, of course I agree with you, Mr. Kenyon. You're the boss."
And that, Jeff thought, was that. But there were a few things Jeff didn't know. He didn't know that Donorama is owned by Cake City, which in turn is a wholly owned subsidiary of Snacks Unlimited, a national distributor of chip and snacking cake products. And Snacks Unlimited is a division of one of the largest conglomerates in the world, Planetary Services Incorporated. And who is the chairman of the board of Planetary Services? David Letterman. Jeff was fired the next day. So learn the lesson Jeff didn't. Know who your real boss is.
Certainly words to grow by. This brings us now to letter number three. "Dear Dave, I was thinking yesterday that a fab idea for you would be for you to have a practical joke show." This is from Sally Davis, Halstead, Pennsylvania. I think Sally is referring to a program like TV's Practical Jokes and Bloopers. Well, Sally, you know, coincidentally, we have been kind of kicking around the idea of a show like that. In fact, Here's a little scene that I think you may be seeing right here on NBC pretty soon.
Our own Paul Schaefer walks right through this doorway here, and then he goes down these stairs. So we thought maybe it would be really funny to put a lot of grease on those steps and see what happens. Let's watch. Are you all right?
Oh, I think it's my spine.
Yeah. All right, letter number four. Dear Dave, what was the man outside your window on your December 3rd Monday show? He had a camera. Sincerely, Barbara Barrett, Seattle, Washington. We looked into this, Barbara. Our show isn't the only production that uses this particular studio. For example, NFL 84 is here on weekends, and you're not going to believe this, but one night we actually caught a Japanese film crew in here trying to make a low-budget science fiction movie. Let's take a look at a scene from that film, and I think you'll recognize a couple of things.
Radiation bomb that went off was very awful. What will happen next? It is the most...
Letter number five. Now, this is an interesting letter. Dave, are you really that goofy looking? Or are the studio cameras fouled up? Randy Townsend, Evanston, Wyoming. Well, yeah, this is, I never really thought of myself as amazingly good looking, but I'm not sure that I would describe myself as, goofy. Hal, are we having difficulty with the cameras? Could that possibly be the problem?
Phil's in trouble, Dave. We're not using that for the moment.
Are you all right, Hal?
I think so, yeah.
There's no one giving birth in there, is there?
Two women in labor, Dave.
Oh, my God. I tell you what, Hal, even though we're having trouble with the camera number three, go ahead and put it on the air so we can see if maybe that's what's causing me to appear goofy looking, okay?
Okay, take her.
Okay. Yeah, well, okay. Apparently that's the problem. Okay. We have one more letter. Is that correct? We're up to letter number six. Dear Dave, last Thursday, the 22nd, you had Liberace on your program, and you cracked an egg with one hand. If possible, could you show how that is done? A very dedicated viewer from Pennsylvania. Well, you've touched on an important aspect of our show. Such tricks as this do seem easy, but in order to look good on television, it actually involves a great deal of work. To better explain, here comes another one of these. Here's a clip from a short documentary narrated by actor Mark Hamill and produced by NBC in association with Futura Optics, a division of Eastman Kodak. Yeah.
Here we go, one-handed.
Okay.
Like much of what you see on late night, this sequence involved a technique known as matting. First, for the close-up shot, Dave's hand is photographed empty in front of a blue screen. Then a positive and a negative print are made of the same scene. Next, model technicians film an egg, also over a blue screen, and a robot camera simulates the exact movement of Dave's hands while tiny explosive charges, or squibs, placed around the egg's equator are ignited. The elements are then brought together in the final stage of optical printing. Finally, sound effects and music are laid down, creating that special magic that late-night viewers have come to demand.
We have reporters standing by at Lenox Hill Hospital and New York Hospital, and we'll be checking in with them in a few minutes to find out if we've had a new arrival. The first baby born during this show will receive more than just the coveted title, Late Night Baby. That lucky child is going to be showered with an assortment of expensive gifts. Let's go right now and take a look at what this child will win. Paul, can we have a little gift music, please? We'll go over here and... Larry, how are you?
Fine.
Nice to see you. Congratulations on the
grand. Thank you.
We have a lovely array of stuff. We'll take a look at it. First of all, the baby will be receiving $500 worth of savings bonds.
That's wonderful.
That'll be very nice.
Yes.
Also, this is a lovely item back here. This is the Civil War chess set from the Franklin Mint. That'll be a nice gift one day. This is good. Do you have one of these, Larry?
No.
You know what this is?
Yeah.
This is a cordless pepper grinder. Also on the lineup, we have... Oh, now when the child becomes 18 years old and wants to go into television, we have this. This is a certificate which guarantees an unpaid internship on this program.
Oh, that's marvelous, yes.
Kind of like the deal we have you on.
Yeah.
What else do we have? Oh, we have the 10-pound rum cake.
I like that.
Uh-huh. And, of course, this little item right here. This is known as the world's most powerful flashlight.
Oh.
So you turn that on like that.
Uh-huh.
And finally, and I would have to say that this is the crowning jewel in the assortment, we have this 8-foot, state-of-the-art, Phantom Engineering satellite dish.
That is unique.
Now, do you know why we say Phantom Engineering?
No.
That's so we can get it free. All right, Larry, now... Here's how this works. We're going to close up these gates now.
Uh-huh.
You play a very important part in awarding the prize to the first baby born during the show.
All right.
Let me just go ahead and lock this up.
Uh-huh.
And nobody's getting in there. What is this, wrought iron? I can't... All right. Now, Larry, here's the deal.
Okay.
Take the key, put it around your neck like that. Now,
we
have a car ready to whisk you to a neutral location.
Okay.
Where I think you've been before. Now, when we get word where the child has been born, either of the two hospitals, you will then go to the hospital, present the key to the prize wonderland to the proud parents.
Right.
Can you handle that?
I think so.
All right, good luck
to you. Thank you,
David. Again, congratulations.
Okay,
nice working with you. What proud father wouldn't want to see Larry come bursting through the doors? You know, we've had many wonderful guests on this show, and as we look back, I'm struck by the way their visits have resulted in surprisingly many delightful moments and surprisingly few really major lawsuits. So, come with us now as we take a sentimental journey with some of the guests who have appeared on this program in the past 3 years.
Well, I usually don't like to talk about the value of things because people... start looking at something and they're only looking at what it's worth, you know, like a great painting. Oh, it's worth $4 million or something. So I just like to, I'll just say they start around $300,000 and can go to $1 million or even two.
$2 million? That's unbelievable. Yeah,
they're going back. For example, this piece back.
Those. Drop the calendar down, if you will, and go right ahead, Edith.
With every failure, David, with every failure, my reputation grows. One of these days, you'll see my picture on every postage stamp. One of these days, I'll feudalize the world.
Is that a Banlon shirt?
The actual tone.
Oh, yeah. That's
now, I understand the birth of your twins was topic for actually a radio talk show. Thank you very much for being here. Come on, don't you want to just say one thing? I love you, Willard. Willard, lose some weight. Just something. I say hi. Hello.
It's sure been fun.
Well, I always have three pointers, and I hope I don't forget them right now. Now, one pointer is, there are three of them, they all begin with the same letter. It's a mnemonic device, and I'm trying to recall what they are. And this is certainly an embarrassing moment.
I know what you're talking about. They begin with the letter O.
That's right. It begins with the letter O. Yeah. That is correct.
And
one is obey the rules.
Obey the rules.
Right. And the other is letter O, obey the rules.
I had them this afternoon. One is often enter.
Enter often, that is correct.
Yeah, often enter.
And the third one?
It slipped my mind. What is the third one, Gerard? Organize your material.
That's right.
That's right.
I'm bringing it just a little bit higher.
That's marvelous.
I'm 8 miles high. You know, I have fun on this show every time I come on this show. Paul, do you know every time?
Yeah.
Every time it rains, it rains. Pennies from heaven. Yeah. I love looking at that.
That's great.
It looks funny, but it saves a life.
This is a nightmare I've had over.
That's got to be realized.
David, you're unconscious.
Okay.
Now, the important thing here is that a small person can use their weight to do the maneuver this way. And we've had children save people this way.
Well, why don't we have one here tonight?
Go ahead.
When you're out in public, do people come up to you? Are you bothered? Are you a security problem?
Well, the drug dealers in West Forth call their drugs by my names and my songs. Like, there's White Wedding, Cocaine, and Rebel Yell Quaaludes, and Dancing With Myself, Smoke, and stuff. So, yeah, people recognize me everywhere, really.
You must be a very proud young man. Thank everybody who was
clean it up.
I want to thank you.
Actually, this is about right.
Mistake at someone else's.
Oh, I see. Well, that's certainly an interesting policy. Here is a copy of a clothing mail order and mountaineering supply kind of catalog.
Yes.
Our lighting director, Cheryl Thacker, brought this to me. And there's a photograph of you in here.
Yes.
You must.
I even suggested to her, and the people out there just reminded me of that, that if she does want to feel something inside her vagina, that it's perfectly all right to either use a cucumber or...
from either of the hospitals. We'll keep you posted. In the past 3 years, we have shown you some things that were a little unusual, some that were a little unexpected, and even some that were downright peculiar. Now we would like to show you something that is all three. It's a little piece called Dog Poetry by my dog, Stan.
Ha ha ha!
Now it's time for Stupid Pet Tricks. For 3 years now, we've been inviting average pet homer pet owners. Oh my gosh. Average pet owners from all over the tri-state area to appear on the show with their pets and the silly little things they have taught them to do. And tonight we're going to show you, again, a sampling of the first 3 years. Our first participant tonight, remember, this is not a competition, it's only an exhibition. Please, no wagering. Now, Ed Barnum, ladies and gentlemen. Ed. Come on. Let's go. Come on. Ed, how are you?
Hi, how are
you? Nice to see you. Good. Welcome to the program. Thank you very much for coming back. Where are you from, Ed?
Glen Cove, Long Island.
And this is your dog?
Pepper.
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 And Pepper will do what for us here?
He's going to stand against this door, and I'm going to put food on his face, and he's not going to move until I tell him to get it.
Going to put food on the dog's face?
On his face.
Well, let me put some on your face, all right? Now, Ed, how did you teach the animal to do this, and I guess more importantly, why?
It was constant reinforcement.
All right. Pepper will stand against the door.
Right.
Do you need anything from me?
No, not right now.
All right. Well, I'll just be over here if anything happens. Hi, Pepper. How are you? What kind of dog is Pepper?
He's a Cocker Spaniel mix.
Cute dog. Nice pet.
You want this?
Sure.
Okay. Yeah.
You want that? Come on. Come on. Sit. Sit up. Now get back against the door. Come on. Up. Up. Get back there. Up. Get up. Don't you move. Don't move.
There are no staples involved with this trick, are there, Ed?
Don't you move. Don't you move. Don't you move. Don't you move. Right. Put your head up. Don't you move. 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 Don't move. Don't. Go ahead.
Very nice, Ed.
Thank you.
Nice to see you again. Here's Pepper in slow motion instant replay. Oh, very nice. Nice to see you, Pepper. Thank you very much for being here. Thanks a lot, Ed. Okay. Good night. All right, our next participant tonight is Barbara Wild. Folks, say hello to Barbara. Hi, Barbara, how are you? Nice to see you. Barbara, where are you from?
We live in Alpine, New Jersey. Mm-hmm.
And by we, you mean you and?
And Dee.
And Dee. What kind of dog is this?
This is a West Highland Terrier.
Uh-huh, nice pet.
Great. I'm talking about births. Dee had, since she was on before, she had 4 babies of her own.
You know, I read about that.
I knew you
were. Okay, refresh our memory. What is it that Dee will do for us
Well,
tonight?
Dee watches television, and what she is right. like a TV buff.
This is pretty bizarre, isn't it?
Well, what she does is actually tell the difference between animals and humans, mm-hmm. and you can actually tell because when she watches TV, she will sit there and just watch humans, and if any animal appears on the set, she actually attacks it.
She goes crazy.
Yeah.
Okay. We have a television monitor there.
Okay.
I guess you've worked all of this out, and can I do anything for you?
Well, we're set.
Okay, go right in.
Right.
This will be a D attacking the TV. All right, there's as close as we could get to a human. No, doesn't seem to do, no. Oh, my goodness.
Watches the spot exactly.
Yeah. Oh, my. That's amazing. Jeez. Good Lord. Thank you very much, Barbara. Nice to see you again. We're going to take a look. Here is Dee in action in slow motion. Nice to see you, Barbara. Thank you very much for coming in. Unbelievable, ladies and gentlemen. Carrie Seller, a name from the past, folks. Say hello to Carrie Seller.
Nice to see you again.
Hi, Carrie. How are you?
Fine, thanks.
This is Buddy, as I recall.
Buddy, nice smile.
Well, thank you. Are you?
Hey, good smile.
What?
Nice smile.
What kind of dog is Buddy?
He's a mutt. I don't know what
mutt.
He is, Dave.
Looks like a kind of a dog's dog.
He's a dog's dog.
All right,
right?
Carrie. What will I have a I believe a vague recollection of what he does, but tell the audience.
Well, you have an alcohol license, right? You're going to sell him beer like you did a couple of months ago on the show.
I'm going to sell beer to the dog.
Right.
All right. This is like a store, a deli, convenience outlet. The
correct.
Dog comes in to buy beer.
That's correct.
I card him. Give him the beer.
Oh, you can card him, sure.
I just stand over here.
Yes, sir, please.
Anything else I should do here?
Well, Buddy, bring this beer.
The dog comes in.
Bring it over here. Hold it for a minute. Wait a minute. Now, he's going to put his feet up here and hand you the beer. Set it right here.
Uh-huh.
And then he's going to pull the money out of the rubber band. You just hold your hand out and he takes it from you.
Okay.
Put the beer in a bag, roll it up real tight, give it back to him and he's gone.
You know, okay.
Okay?
That's the kind of place this is. Most of the customers come in, put their feet up here.
That's
on the
counter. That's all they want is the beer. We don't want to stay around.
Okay, all right, so he comes up. All right, he comes in with the beer.
Yeah.
All right.
Yeah, okay.
There's the beer. I take the beer.
Right, put it over here.
All right. You see the Super Bowl? All right, then I take
the
money.
Put the change in the bag, sure.
Put the money in there.
Roll it up nice and tight and give it back to him.
Change for?
Change for?
I don't have any change.
No, that
four beers, $20. That's it.
Okay.
All right.
Hey, you're wagging your tail there, huh?
There you go. Bye-bye.
Thanks a lot, dude.
Well, good luck next year.
Thank you very much.
Good
nice
luck.
To see you again, Jerry.
Okay. Oh, yeah, let's take a look at Buddy in slow motion buying beer. Another satisfied customer. Okay, there you go. Some stupid pet tricks.
We're going now to Lenox Hill Hospital. Remember, we're awaiting the birth of the baby, a baby, at either of these two hospitals. Let's check in now at Lenox Hill with NFL sportscaster Bob Costas. Bob, what's new there? Anything we should know about?
Well, Dave, as you can see, it's a festive atmosphere here as we await the arrival of the first ever late night baby. The cake awaits the arrival of the guest of honor. The cigars are at the ready, but of course, we need the baby. With us is Nurse Jean Foley, who heads the patient care unit in the labor and delivery area. I understand you have two women in labor right now.
Yes, we do. Both of them are in early labor, though.
And so we could guess about when for the arrival of a baby.
Well, it's the first baby for both of them, so it could be 8 or 10 hours.
Oh, great. Wait a minute. Hold it. Bob, explain,
yeah,
to
Dave.
Explain that this is television. We don't have 8 or 10 hours.
All right, Dave. Considering what's at stake here, Nurse Foley, is there any way to speed this thing up?
No, there isn't. No.
I'm sorry, Dave. The best I can tell you is that we'll continue to stand watch on all the pre- and postnatal action. Back to you.
Eight or 10 hours. Boy, what a good idea this is looking to be. Yes, sir, I like the looks of this idea more and more here. All right. 8 or 10 hours. Well, folks, make yourselves comfortable. We'll get the hot soup and the blankets. All right, now we're going to New York Hospital. Perhaps we have something a little earlier than 8 or 10 hours. This is like checking on flights to Cleveland, isn't it? We're going to check in now with Vince McMahon. Vince, what's going on at New York Hospital?
Well, actually, the word is out, of course, on the late-night baby, and we are experiencing, or in anticipation of, certainly a deluge of pregnant women at this moment on their way down to the waiting room. However, we have been told by Dr. Saxon that there is a Mrs. Fury that has about a 30% chance of delivering within the hour. Somewhat long odds. With me right now, however,
what did he say?
John long Martino, odds. And John, you came through, but you came through a little bit too early, about 35 minutes too early. Have you always been a little early with everything you do?
Well, not all the time, but we try hard.
Well, congratulations, a bouncing baby girl.
Thank you.
Perhaps
thank you.
A former or perhaps a future lady wrestler.
Well, yeah, good idea. Good idea.
Question?
Now, Vince, I'm sorry, is that a new father there?
This is a new father.
Well,
sure.
By all means, tell him congratulations on our behalf, and we're sorry that his daughter is not eligible for the late-night baby competition, but good luck.
Best of luck to you. Back to you.
Vince, I have a question for you also.
Yes, David.
Is that your tuxedo?
No, actually, it's not.
Okay. Okay, well, things are going better than ever. You know,
here at Late Night, we've always felt that our first duty was to entertain, our second duty was to inform, and somewhere down around 9th or 10th was our duty to explore the fundamental principles of science. Here now are the results of our experiments.
How about a nice styrofoam cooler of beer?
Cooler full of beer.
There you are, getting everywhere.
Yes, sir. The one beer to mash when you're mashing more than one.
Thank you all very much.
Wile E. Coyote, one from the cartoon.
Sure, we love to recreate classic cartoon moments. And today, a little something from the Roadrunner.
I want to see a Mexican piñata and fill it with baked beans.
Yeah, wish somebody was supervising these requests.
Get going. It's dangerous, it's exciting, it's sick. A bowling ball. A volleyball with a nylon carcass.
Show me something I can tell my grandchildren about years from now.
You know, I think that's an important consideration for all of us. And believe me, ma'am, you've come to the right place.
All right, we're going now to check in with Larry, who holds the key to the prize wonderland. He's now at a neutral position somewhere in Manhattan. I believe he's at 71st Street and 3rd Avenue. And when we get the word, he'll whisk the key for the prize wonderland to the winning hospital site. Larry, can you hear me?
Yes.
How would you describe the atmosphere on the street there, Larry?
Hey, hi, Dave. Am I an uncle yet?
Are you riding home with Vince tonight, Larry?
Not really.
How would you describe the atmosphere, the feeling on the street tonight?
Well, the mood here on the street is ugly. Whether it's impatience or simple fear of the unknown, I couldn't say.
Could we talk to a couple of folks who happen to be strolling by?
Why, sure.
All right. This will be good.
What's your name?
Kathy Durkin.
Have you ever experienced a miracle of childbirth? I bet you have. Oh, here is a cigar. Oh. How many children do you have?
Five.
Do they like to go to the beach?
Yes, they do.
You look like a woman who enjoys a good cigar. Well, too bad. This is the only kind I have. Hi, Dave. Am I an uncle yet?
No.
What's your name?
Irving Gell.
Oh, okay. Just excuse me, Larry.
Yes.
I hate to interrupt, but I believe we have some interesting news at New York Hospital.
We do?
Yes, we do.
I'm an uncle.
Let's now go to, is this right? Vince McMahon at New York Hospital. Are they ready there at New York Hospital?
We're on. We're all right here, and I'll tell you right now, we have good news. Mrs. Fury has been in overdrive, and she has come through, and Dr. Ledger and Dr. Davis came through, and I understand everything's just fine.
Where
be
did we get this guy?
So we have a festive occasion here, and it's all time we say, happy birthday to you, happy birthday to you, Happy birthday, dear Moon. Happy birthday
what?
To you.
Okay.
All right, Dave, right. We did it. All right.
All right, Vince. Boy, you can certainly cut the electricity here in the studio with a knife. So I guess we'll get the all of the information and we'll check back with them. But we do have a winner, and it's a baby
winner.
Girl. We don't know. Well, don't leave it up to Vince, for God's sake. A baby boy. Okay. We'll get all of the data and edit as much as we can out of this. Now, every now and then, what we like to do is go out of the studio, go out onto the streets, and badger total strangers with a lot of questions. Sometimes we even bring along our cameras. When we do this, we call these remote segments. Here now are some of our favorites over the last 3 years.
Well, here we are in the land of sunshine and palm trees. Boy, oh boy, is it exciting to be here. Hollywood, California. Do you get a lot of stars in here, George?
Quite a few.
Yeah? Like, can you give us any names?
Names I don't remember. I look at faces, I recognize faces, but names I'm...
Could you describe a face or two for us?
Oh, somebody from...
I don't remember either.
No, but right over my right shoulder. Legendary actor Cesar Romero. How you doing? Okay. How many donuts a day should a person eat?
About 115 dozen a day.
Eating is not such a great experience for me. I'd rather dance. You want me to give you New York, New York?
Yeah, let's see a little of that. Now remember, don't get crazy. You just had a hamburger.
New York, New York.
Now you see this sign up here that says the richness that is woman?
Yeah.
What does that mean?
Ladies getting construction jobs. No, I can't mean that.
Ladies get construction jobs?
It's good. What you looking at? It's good, I don't know.
Are you in a hurry?
Yeah.
Am I keeping you?
Gotta pay the rent. You know what I mean?
I know it.
Hey, look. Let me see my... And you can...
No, you're done, Frank. You're done. You're done. Bye-bye.
The name of the store is Just Bulbs, and that's exactly what we sell, Just Bulbs.
Okay, so besides bulbs, what do you have here?
Nothing.
How about shades? Could you get shades here?
No, we are Just Bulbs. If you want shades, maybe go to a place called Just Shades.
We sell nothing but lamps at discount prices.
What is the name of the store?
Just Shades.
And what can you get in here?
What can you get in here? Only shades. That's why our name is Just Shades.
But seriously, what can you get besides shades here? Earlier this week, work began on the tunnel that will connect Roosevelt Island with the city of New York on Manhattan. How's the work progressing?
Well, we're not tunnel. We're looking for a gas main.
How long does it usually take you to find a gas main?
Well, we found it, but we're not what we're looking for. We're looking for IJ couplings. We got put,
looking for I.J. Cupman?
That's right.
How long has he been missing?
How do you do? Can I ask you what you have in your bag?
Oh, you could be a stewardess.
A stewardess? Or a I like that. I tell you what, I think I'm going to have the stewardess made up, all right?
Okay, just fill out your name.
Do you get the feeling a lot of people are impersonating stewardesses?
Yeah.
How you doing? What do you have in your bag here?
What I got in my bag?
What's in the bag?
Well, you want to ask me?
I'm just curious.
Clothes.
What kind of clothing?
You want to just put.
Oh, yeah? Can we take a look at it?
Show me the idea first. I want to know what I'm talking with.
Joe Friday, homicide. Let's see the clothing. Okay, so here we are at 7th Avenue and 55th, and it's true what they say about New York, anything you want. This is the Optician Coffee Shop. I'll show you what I mean.
I'll have some of this cake, and also, these things keep slipping down. So if you just tighten them up, I don't know whether to tighten them up here or tighten them up there, but you know, they keep coming down. Could you fix those for me?
No, thank you.
What do you mean, no, thank you?
I mean, I don't know how to visit.
Oh, you're teasing me now.
Yeah.
You're joking. Okay. All right, well, no, just tighten them up then a little bit because they slide down. Okay?
All right.
Okay, great. 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 So and I'd like to look at some frames for sunglasses, too. Real, like, Italian kind of... Can you hear me, Leo?
Yes, I hear you.
Okay.
Have you ever seen the world's largest humidor?
No, I haven't.
Any interest in that?
None whatsoever.
You can keep the cookie, but lose the Wookiee, would you?
Why?
Oh, it's just...
Is that?
No, it's cookie the worst. Cookie. It's just...
Love it. Have you ever eaten our cookie Wookiee?
I'm sure it's a wonderful product, but the it's sign great. Is making us all sick.
Oh, not us. We love it. Cookie Wookiee.
Oh, ma'am, you're an adult.
And then we have brown brownie, too.
No, get rid of the damn sign, please.
What's your definition of love?
Love? Love is a tremendous feeling for the person that you think about constantly, and it gives good meaning to everything you do in your life.
Yeah. What is your definition of sciatica?
Sciatica is a pain running down your leg.
Thank you very much, Doctor.
Some of the islanders now doing Elvis.
Life detector to avoid being embalmed or buried alive. The premise is, now, if a loved one appears to be dead, is loaded into the coffin, locked into the box, and is still alive, this alarm system will let the loved ones know that Uncle Herb is not gone yet. Could you ask Roberto, does this happen a lot?
Yes, he told me to tell you that he was buried alive 3 times, and he got a little worried about it. So now he developed this idea.
You know, I don't think it's any secret that the really big stars like a good discount as much as you and I do. And so go on inside here, and we'll talk to the man who runs the Hollywood Discount Center. Say Joan Collins walked in tomorrow. What would you try to sell her?
Whatever she like.
Yeah. What do you think that she might want?
I don't know. Really, maybe shower curtain, bedspread. They have so many linen, you know.
Yeah. I think we're in luck. I don't know if you can see her now. She just went by. Star of Dynasty, Joan Collins. Joan!
Let me briefly give you some information. We have a baby. The father is John Fury. The mother is Mary Fury. This is their first child. It's a baby boy, Sean Michael, and... we will be going to the hospital as soon as Larry gets through traffic. And in the meantime, the new father gets a chance to chat with Vince. So, but we're terrifically delighted for those folks. And they get all of the cash stuff. And we'll chat with the father, at least, in a couple of minutes. 3 years ago, when we started doing this program, we had a choice. It could be used as a powerful educational tool, or it could be used to stage a lot of flashy stunts just to get some cheap applause. When you take a look at this videotape, I hope you'll agree that we made the right decision.
Tonight, an NBC late night exclusive, The Russian versus the Bloodhound. December 6, 1983, with only the scent from one of his shirts to guide them, a team of bloodhounds successfully track down and apprehend announcer Bill Wendell. Tonight, they'll be going up against the Russian, Lev Schneider. 1 week earlier, he used his incredible psychic powers to perform a similar feat of detection. His prey, a hidden bag of hair. Tonight, East meets West in a dramatic showdown, the Russian versus the Bloodhound, next. Asked about 12 times by various members of the staff to remind you, don't try this at home. I know you have the 900-gallon tank. I know you have the oxygen. I know you have the suit of Alka-Seltzer and a staff of 100 people. No! Do release my feet? Or release your feet.
You're not in
the
game.
It was the
By the additional weight, has fallen behind, and David Letterman, surging to the finish line, is an easy winner over Paul Schaefer.
A new set here. Did you realize that?
Yeah. It's nice to see, too. It's a whole different thing back there. I have no lights like you have, though. Can I get lights?
Well, maybe next year we can get you some
lights.
Year.
All right. We make it that far.
We're going to go back to New York Hospital now, and we have a baby which has been born there shortly, not too long ago, rather. It's a baby boy. Sean Michael is the kid's name, and Vince and Larry is there to award the key. And I understand, Vince, you don't have the father just yet, but who is the woman you're standing with?
No, but we're working on the father. He's on his way up, and certainly Larry's looking forward to interviewing the father and presenting a little something, as we understand. But joining us right now, Valerie Lewis, who was an eyewitness, indeed part of the whole situation down in the operating room. And, Bud, you're going to ask a few questions.
Valerie, how's the baby? How's the mom?
The baby is excellent, has an almost perfect Apgar 910, and the mother is recuperating nicely.
Yeah. Thank you.
I have a question for you, Larry. Is that your tux?
No, it's not.
When it comes to finding performers for the program, we could do the easy thing and book a lot of high-priced professional actors, or we could give some of our own staff members a chance in the spotlight. As we page through our late-night family album, I think you'll agree that we did the thing that cost the least. Jeff Aquilon, who is a male model.
Dave?
Oh, yeah. Yes, sir. What can I do for you?
Do you have any A1 sauce?
Welcome to New York, sometimes called Fun City. How is your... And where are you from?
From the Eastern Shore of Virginia.
Oh. Do you have any questions about New York? That's for sure. Did you have a snack on the way? Well, won't you please?
To tell us which one was actually lower in cholesterol. Chris Elliott, ladies and gentlemen. Chris, go ahead and okay. Conduct the experiment.
Dave, I can't tell any difference.
Oh, I'm telling you the truth. You're so good, you know.
Dave, shaft 9 just collapsed.
This brings us to letter number 3. Dear Dave, this man must be stopped. His plan is to take over the world and make us all look and dress like he does. We've tried to stop this evil but have failed. You are our last hope. Please save us. Ken Cole, Colorado Springs, Colorado. Frankly, some of this mail is just stupid. Here we are slandering a perfectly nice man just for the sake of what? A stupid joke. We don't even know who this man is, and all of a sudden, we're making a joke out of him. Paul, do you know who this guy is? Have you ever seen this man before? Any idea?
Yes, Dave! That is Mr. Roland Pastel, our beloved and trusted leader!
All right, Paul. Thank you very much. Thank you very much for everything.
Thank you, David. I'm thrilled that you picked that clip, too.
And Bill, thank you very much. I
thank
appreciate
you, Dave.
Everything you've
Three
done.
Three years of great pleasure.
And also my thanks to Chris Elliott. Chris, that was just terrific. Thank you very much. Very nice job. You know, when you look at your appearances on the program, and everybody seems to love them, do you have any idea why they're so successful?
I really don't. I'm just very happy that they are, and congratulations on your anniversary.
Well, thank you very much. You know, now Chris, I had kind of an idea why they're so successful. You know, I think it's those silly little costumes.
Silly little costumes.
Yeah, you know, the little stuff you put on your head and so forth.
Oh, yeah, I guess you're right, Dave. I guess talent has nothing to do with it.
Now, Chris, I didn't want to get into this.
You know something, mister? One of these days, I might just have to knock the wind out of your sails. But until that day, I'll be right here, making your life a living hell. Watching you. Watching everything you do. If I see that damn Alka-Seltzer suit again, I don't know what I'll do.
I'm watching you, Dave. Happy anniversary.
Okay, good enough. We want to go back to New York Hospital, and Vince, and I understand he has the father and also the doctor who delivered the young baby, Shawn Michael. Vince, go ahead and introduce the folks there, will you?
Yes,
sir?
Indeed, we have here to my left Dr. Davis, who delivered the bouncing baby boy, and to my right, the father of the late night baby, as a matter of fact. He had a little something to do with it. John, congratulations. And we understand that, Larry Bud, you have a special presentation.
Yes. Here is the key. May your child's life be as full, rewarding, and successful as my own.
Vince, could I say hello to John for just a second?
You bet.
John, congratulations. We certainly are very pleased for you, and this must be a really peculiar time to find yourself on television, huh?
Definitely.
Are there people that you would like to say hello to? You have family and friends that would be interested in knowing about this?
Yeah, my parents and my wife's parents.
Well, again, congratulations, and we really appreciate you letting us sort of eavesdrop on this. It's been a lot of fun for us. Congratulations again.
No problem.
Nice talking with you, John.
Okay.
And no problem for him, of course. And Vince, be sure and tell John to give our best to his wife, Mary, and to his brand new son.
You bet.
Thank you very much. Now what are we doing? Oh, my goodness. all right, I want to thank everybody who helped us out tonight. Of course, Vince McMahon, and let's say goodnight to Bob Costas. We haven't talked to Bob since early on in the proceedings. Bob, thank you very much. We appreciate your help as always.
Well, thank you, David, and the party is continuing apace. Most of the staff on hand here, meanwhile, the plaintive cries of desperately ill men and women go unheeded. David?
Well, we knew something would get shortchanged. I want to thank, of course, Paul and the band, Will Lee, Steve Jordan, Sid McGinnis, and Mr. David Sanborn for sitting in. Thanks for a good year, gentlemen. Thanks to Bill Wendell, our announcer. I want to thank everybody on our production crew, production staff, and everybody on our technical crew for all of the hard work that they do every night of this show. We've had a wonderful time. Thank you to our studio audience. You folks are always terrific. Have a good weekend. Good night.